Yeah, thanks, Danico. I'm with Tevita Pangai Jr., mate. Tough loss to take.
Yeah, it's been tough. Tough 2 years, 18 months for the club, and it was tough tonight.
I spoke to the CEO, Dave Donaghy, earlier. He did confirm reports that you're allowed to look elsewhere. So where's your future at?
Right now, I'm on contract for this year, next year, but yeah, they got me in on my day off and told me that I'm free to look elsewhere. So, you know, players have got to be held accountable for the results that we've been tossing up. So if that's me, then I have to look elsewhere. But just got to take it day by day, week by week, and see where my future is.
So is this the last time we'll see you in a Broncos jersey?
We've got one game in the next 3 weeks, so... yeah, I'd like to get my future sorted in the next 3 weeks, but like I said, we've got one game in the next month or so, so I'd like to get my future sorted.
Where do you see your future?
I don't know. I haven't thought about that. No, I thought I was on contract, but contracts don't mean much these days, so yeah, I just got to cop it on the chin and get my manager to do his job, and yeah.
No worries, mate. Well, all the best for the rest of the year and for the future as well. Over to you, James Bracey.
Thank you very much. Jonathan Thurston there with Tevita Pangai. Quite a revealing interview there in the end with JT and Tevita. Stunning stuff, isn't it, knowing that he has been told, the Broncos star, he can look elsewhere with 18 months still to go on his contract. Brad Fittler, Andrew Johns, Alana Ferguson with me in the studio for Hisense Thursday night knockoff on the back of that 46-0 win. I guess... Yeah, Alana, when you look at this situation where the Broncos are at the moment, summed up on the field and right there in that interview with Jonathan Thurston and Tevita Pangai off it.
Yeah, absolutely. He didn't have much to say, and it's sort of how they were playing. They didn't have many answers out there. There wasn't enough going right. In patches, in the beginning, the first 20-odd minutes, their defence looked OK, but I still thought their edges looked quite vulnerable and the game just kept slipping further and further away from them, and they couldn't produce anything. There was not one point during that game where they looked dangerous and they looked like they could be in control.
Didn't you tip them at the start?
Mate, I said if they were a chance of winning, this is okay. What they have to do. I didn't say they were going to come out and flog South.
Don't worry,
so thank you for that.
I was just waiting for them to jump down
I'm glad
the
I could clarify it, actually.
Build them up so much. I was just...
Yeah, look, this is pretty big news developing throughout this game, but Broncos CEO Dave Donaghy did confirm to us at halftime that the club has given Tevita Pangai Jr. permission to look around despite being contracted for the remainder of this season and next season as well. And there is a bit of speculation that the Tigers could be the front runners, and Jonathan Thurston spoke to Tevita at full time.
It certainly has become very public very quickly. I'd love to get the thoughts of our panel here on where this one sits at the moment. How quickly do you deal with this, Andrew, with a year and a half to go on the contract?
No idea. From Tevita's point of view?
Yeah, if you're Tevita, if you're the club, do you make it happen fast, find a suitor?
Wouldn't have a clue. Well, it's only just sort of a... We've only just found out. I don't know what happens here, Freddie. Does he... decide he wants to go now?
Well,
but it sounded like
well,
that,
there's a contract, so if he doesn't want to leave, he can take up his money and take the contract. So at the end of the day, he'll make sure he go to another club because it's within, I think they pushed back the time from June 30 even to another week or so longer, maybe. Mm. But I think you'll find one of those clubs that are sitting at the bottom will see him as a strike. Brisbane will pay a lot of his contract, and that'll happen pretty soon because given what happened just on TV then, I think, you know, it's quite poor form from both parties, really. Mm. Seriously, do we need to be known on the day of a game that, you know, a player's been let go and, you know, then, you know, his reaction I don't think was fantastic either.
It's a watch this space scenario, no doubt, Danica, with where this is at the moment. So we'll see how it all unfolds from here. What else do we need to know tonight?
Yes, it certainly is a developing situation, and we will stay across it. But Tevita Pangai Jr. is also on report tonight, so he'll have a little bit of a nervous wait with the match review committee. He was put on report for this crusher tackle on Cameron Murray. His teammate Payne Haas was also put on report in the match as well. His was for a high shot on Cameron Murray as well.